is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more are you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away.
Absolute pleasure interviewing you. First of all, I've seen you on Broadway in The Lion King. You were just spectacular.
Oh, thank you
and
so much.
And you were, you know, it's great. It's another great Disney.
I had a great supporting cast.
Yeah, yeah, you certainly did.
Yeah, I did.
You certainly did. Okay. All right, so Mr. Wright, I've seen you in an incredible amount of things on Broadway in The Lion King, and you're well known as one of the premier singing voices in Disney films. Sebastian, the role of Sebastian, is probably one of the most popular Disney roles of all time, at least in my opinion.
Yes.
I love your part. You were just so heartwarming, and you were just, it's such an adorable part.
Thank you.
Yeah, well, it must have been like the role of a lifetime to do this.
Well, yes, it's turned out to be that way,
mm-hmm.
the role of a lifetime.
Mm-hmm.
I've always wanted to work for Disney.
Right.
Disney Animation and Disney Films. And when the opportunity gave itself to me, I took it with relish.
Mm-hmm.
And as you know, we were entering a new renaissance with Disney.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody was working really hard on this film. And magic came together at a moment in time and produced The Little Mermaid,
mm-hmm.
which, of course, is a striking event in my life, along with all the other things that have happened. But, boy, this one is stellar.
I heard you auditioned like you were singing on a Broadway musical. It was and that impressed them so much.
Well, when I met Howard and Alan,
mm-hmm.
they had 3-day-old growth beards because they had been writing. They had been shoved in a little room on 42nd Street and 8th Avenue.
Oh, wow.
And that's where I went to do the audition.
Right.
And I walked in the door and I said to them, I said, okay, this song is a little slow, because it was slow in the beginning. It was
right.
more ballady-like. I said, can I speed this up? So Alan looked at me suspiciously and said, well, what do you mean speed it up?
Mm-hmm.
And Howard said, no, let him try it out, let him try it out. So Alan sped it up, and I sung Under the Sea, and I jumped mm-hmm. on tables, and I flipped around. I'm sure they thought I was going to kill them or something. And after I finished, they actually looked at me and said, don't call us, we'll call you.
Really?
Yeah, literally.
Really?
And a year later, I thought it was over. I thought
right.
I'd just blown the whole role.
Uh-huh.
And a year later, I got a call.
Fantastic. Well, they were so impressed. From what I read, they were so impressed with your audition that they knew you were the one for the role. But they originally cast it differently,
yes.
I think. And they had a different style. It was, like you said, a slower style.
Yes, yes. He was a turtle at one particular point.
Oh, wow.
I don't know how he could have been a turtle. But one of the greatest things about Howard was that Howard has an affinity for calypso music,
mm-hmm.
as we see, specifically music of Trinidad.
Right.
And I couldn't do a Jamaican accent.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know
really?
How to do, no, I couldn't do a Jamaican accent. I could do a Trinidadian accent.
Mm-hmm.
Now, a lot of people don't know that there's a difference, but
right.
those of you who do know that there's a difference.
Got it.
And I started doing this accent, and Howard said, stop, what are you doing? And I said, mm-hmm. oh, I'm sorry, I can't do a Jamaican accent. He said, no, that's the accent mm-hmm. I want.
Mm-hmm.
And I went, oh, because
mm-hmm.
he had spent time, apparently, in his life on the island.
Got it.
And that's the sound he wanted. It's a little softer than Jamaica.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's not as hard as a Jamaican accent.
Right. Well, it's a beautiful accent.
Yes, I know.
So cute. And which song do you prefer? I mean, Kiss the Girl, I'm partial. I love Under the Sea,
yeah.
but I love Kiss the Girl. Those two songs.
Yeah.
I mean, I watched it several times before coming today.
Yeah.
It's just so adorable.
I love the lyrics in mm-hmm. Under the Sea.
Mm-hmm.
I love the lyrics.
Right.
I love the musicality of the music in me, the Broadway in me loves.
Mm-hmm.
There you see.
Right.
I love that. You know, it's just such a beautiful lilting phrase. And yeah, so I love both of them. Mm-hmm. I guess that's why both of them were nominated.
Yes.
Did you know that?
Yeah, I did.
That was magic in itself that both songs, but I could have won either way.
You could have.
No, I couldn't have.
Well, I wish you had. I wish you had. But you had some other sequels to The Little Mermaid. There was like, and you have your own CD,
yes,
too, like
yes.
Sebastian's. It's like a.
Yes, Sebastian and myself became separated somewhere along the line. And I became his human companion, Sam, mm-hmm. so then they could do videos of me running around with Sebastian and the kitties and having a great time. Those kitties nowadays, they send me back letters. They are grown with children.
Right.
Kids that were in
of
the
course.
Videos, grown.
Yes.
It's amazing. And we did a lot of, we did prequels and we did a lot of stuff. Mm-hmm. I just remember through the years, my whole life has been completely inundated with the character, which
yes.
is okay with me because he is part of me.
That's great. Well, he's one of the most popular of all the Disney characters. In fact, he's my favorite character of all Disney films.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So
when
they asked me to interview you, I was beside myself with glee because, I mean, he is the cutest character. He is the cutest character.
And I think that's a great compliment because he looks like me.
Yeah.
He's got little bags under his eyes. He's supposed to look like me, actually.
That's,
when
yeah.
Disney films,
right.
they film you during your work, and then they animate it. So everything that you did, they put into the film. Now.
Right.
See?
That's very, very cute.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's he is very popular. When I told people that I was going to be interviewing you today, they were like, "That is so cool." They were really excited for me.
They probably think I'm about this tall.
No,
you
they
tell
know.
Them I'm 6'3".
Okay, no, they obviously know it's your voice, not you know that you're not an animated character, but you know it's a very popular character.
Thank you.
And the singing is so beautiful in all the songs that you sang in the show.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. I will tell you, I had a great leader. Howard was just brilliant and knew exactly what he wanted, and he let me go. I was one of the first actors that was, I call, an ad-lib actor in the animation, because an animation is so specific. You have to be a specific voice to film. But after a while, they said, "Sam, we know we told you to not do all of this stuff, but could you come back and do all of those squiggles and wheels and things that Sebastian do,
mm-hmm.
and we'll stick it in the film?"
That's great.
And I went, and I saw it, and I went, "Oh my goodness, it did work." Because
mm-hmm.
I'm an actor. I'm not a voiceover actor.
Right.
I'm just a...
You've done a lot of Broadway.
Yeah.
I've seen a lot of Broadway that you've done as well.
Yeah, I have one of the dubious honors of being a Broadway baby.
Mm-hmm.
That means I've done a certain number of shows. I've done over 18 Broadway shows. So.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, yeah. I spent my life there.
Which was your favorite Broadway show? I mean, I know you played Mufasa on Broadway in Lion King, but of all the shows you've done...
That I've done? Now, I get asked that question a lot,
mm-hmm.
and I'm going to be very honest about this.
You like them all?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I like the one that I'm doing at the time.
That's right. That's true.
Because as soon as it's over, you have to get rid of it. You
mm-hmm.
can't retain that all that information.
True.
And then reestablish some more information. So, no, everything, the next show I do, I'll probably love it as much as Lion King.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Is there a show, like, that you would love to do on Broadway? Like, if it was brought back any time in any period or any show from the past that you've ever wanted to do?
I did?
Yes. Or that you haven't done that you'd like to do?
I would love the opportunity to do Mary in Jesus Christ Superstar again. I did it one night.
Oh, yeah.
She lost her voice, and I was on a backstage microphone, and...
Oh, that's...
I don't know how to...
Yeah.
And I did her.
That's really...
Yeah.
That's great.
But when you're in a pinch on Broadway, mm-hmm. you do what you have to do.
Exactly.
They just grab you and say, "Get out there, kid, do it."
That's fantastic. Fantastic. So you would like to do that? Anything else that you could think of?
No, I love Broadway.
Mm-hmm.
I love Broadway, but it's a gruel.
It is, yeah.
It's a gruel. It's like 8 shows a week.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And it's a young man's game.
Mm-hmm.
When you get to be my age, you don't look forward to doing it.
So do you want to do more voiceovers for different Disney films or any other films?
I actually did another voiceover for a Disney film. I did
Dinosaur, right?
I did the voice of Crone.
Okay. That was brilliant, by the way. I saw that.
I think that Dinosaur too. Anyway,
yes.
Never mind. Don't get me on that.
I love that.
But it was a great movie.
I thought so.
That's the one movie that's made me cry.
Mm-hmm.
That's animated. And yeah, I love that.
Yeah, me too. I saw it.
You did? Thank you. Because yeah. Nobody has seen it.
Go, I saw it. I see every day.
Dinosaurs, you mean? I said, no.
I saw it. I loved it.
It was good. Mm-hmm. I'm glad you got a chance.
Yeah. But what's next for you after, you know, anything coming up?
Well, now I'm on a fixed income, which means that I'm retired, supposedly. But I work hither and thither, and I have a school.
Oh.
And a theatrical school, and I have a theater.
Oh, where is it? In North Carolina?
No, it's in Walden, New York, in upstate New York.
Really?
Yeah, right here at home. And we have over 300 students, and we've matriculated two groups of several groups of kids that are now out and performing. So that's what my passion is now. It's like teaching kids and giving back for all they gave to me from the Little Mermaid.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
So how do people find out about your, like, can you tell people how they can get involved with
it? It's on a website.
Okay.
Just look for HVC.com.
HVC.com.
That's it.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
So, but you don't want to do any more movies or anything?
Actors never say no.
Yeah.
They never say no. And if I'm asked, I will certainly do something. But I don't rush around and seek it so much as I used to do it when I was a kid. I mean, I'm a new grandfather now, and I have my own little one to look after. So, I'd much rather be home than to be eating bagels in New York all day long and then doing a show.
Yeah, got it. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for this interview.
Oh, thank you. It was a pleasure.
Pleasure to meet you.